Alright guys, welcome back to the channel, where today we're taking a look at the latest uploads to community creations in WWE 2K23, with today's roundup including a bunch of new legends, alternate attires, and new and updated superstars. So let's take a look at the first of today's creations, where we're starting out with some new legends, with the first of these seeing the return of Mr. T, as Tatboy Grimm is continuing to bless us with some incredible celebrity creations, where the latest sees him recreate Mr. T's attire from last year's DLC. While the first attire hides a lot of the creation due to the outfit, switching over to the second attire, Grimm's also included this alternate outfit with Mr. T in his more traditional look, featuring overalls and golden chains. Also from Tatboy Grimm, we have this awesome version of WWE Hall of Famer Tatanka, as Grimm's recreated his look from the Legends DLC that we got in WWE 2K17. Given that recent appearance, Tatanka also comes with his official entrance and victory motions, with a matching render image also included. For those interested in the arena, the one that I used for the video is WrestleMania 2 by creator King Takeover Wu, #12203. So if you're sick of always using the SummerSlam 88 arena and you want a new classic arena to use, then check out this creator, as they've got a bunch of classic arenas up for download. Next up, we have another legend offering, as Dr. Gorilla Nuts has just released this new Mr. Perfect, which is the latest addition to the Icons of the Ring series. Taking a look at the attires, there's two outfits included with this one. The first one sees Kurt in his most familiar blue singlet, while the second one sees him in orange. Next on the list, we have a more modern legend, as What's the Status has uploaded a new version of Triple H, which has been modded to remove his hair, giving us this bald Triple H based on his run between 2013 and 2016. In terms of attires, there's two included with this one, the first one being his 2013 attire that was featured in WWE 2K15, while the second one is the attire that he had in 2K16. As for any extras, Status has also set this one up as an alt for the regular Triple H, so once you download it, it'll automatically be applied as an alternate attire, where it also features Triple H's commentary and his ring name.
Yeah, the game will stop at nothing. He'll use every tool at his disposal to win the matchup. That is why he has become maybe the greatest of all time.
Jumping back to the present, we have a newly updated version of Nikki Cross, with this one coming via Miss Bella Orton, as she was able to update the Nikki ASH model and remove the mask, before then giving her a complete makeover with the addition of a new face texture and an updated hairstyle. Also updated are the entrance and victory settings, as they've been set to use Nikki Cross's motions rather than Nikki ASH, so if you download this one, I would suggest keeping it as a separate character rather than setting this as an alt, otherwise you'll lose the updated entrance. Alongside the main attire, also included is a second outfit that sees Nikki in black and pink gear, with this attire also featuring a completely different hairstyle, so you've got two options to choose from. Another star receiving an update is Logan Paul, as Will Amazing has released this updated version of Logan that features his new blue and yellow outfit. However, the biggest change is the absence of the headband, as while it isn't generally possible to remove it, Will's actually found a way to remove the 3D part and then cover up the remainder using hair dye, resulting in this version of Logan without the headband. Along with the main attire, also included is a second outfit featuring another of Logan's blue and yellow attires, though rather than remove the headband, this one sees it updated to match the outfit. Next up, we have a new superstar that you can add to the roster. Xantronexi has released a new version of Maxine Dupri, with this version seeing her as part of Alpha Academy. Originally, there were plans for Maxine to be a part of the game, as the developers did include her motions as part of several manager entrances for the Maximum Mill models, though while the motions made it into the game, unfortunately she didn't. Moving on, and next up we have the return of Eva Marie, as L2K Games has put together this awesome version of Eva, which is based on a return to WWE in 2021. In terms of attires, along with the main purple outfit, also included are two additional options, as the second attire sees Eva with this golden pink outfit as her ring attire, while the entrance attire sees her in white, so depending on which of these you prefer, you can set one of them in the creation suite and then delete the other. Moving over to AEW, we have some big name creations up for download, the first of which is Kenny Omega, as Phenom Cause has released this version of Kenny, which comes complete with two outfits, one that sees him in these black tights with a flame design, while the other one sees him in these similar blue ones. Also from AEW, we have John Moxley from Warning #46959 as they've released a really good version of Mox that sees him in these black tights with a flaming Mox logo as the main attire, while the second one sees him in these maroon pants with a jacket for the Blackpool Combat Club. Next up, we have a new version of Edge, as Kalua has followed up his Attitude Era Edge with his custom version, which is based on Edge in 2007. Rather than use the official model that we see in 2K Showcase, this version, which is part of a collaboration between Kalua and What's the Status, is actually a completely custom one, as they've created their own version of Edge, which Status has then modded to work as an alternate attire to the in-game model, as this one is automatically applied to the in-game Edge, and therefore also comes with his ring name and commentary.
You know, Edge has won and cashed in the very first Money in the Bank contract, and he's found so many unique ways to win. He is truly the ultimate opportunist.
Switching over to the second attire, we also have Edge with this alternate hairstyle, as the second outfit uses the headpiece trick to flatten the hair, which kind of gives it this thinner looking wet appearance. For any WCW fans, we also have some new WCW legends to share, starting out with the icon Sting. As stepping out of retirement, creator Jenna has returned to bring us this new version of Sting, which is based on his later run in WCW. Alongside Sting, Jenna's also just released this awesome version of WCW Road Wild 97, so if you're looking for some new arenas to build out a WCW universe, then this one would make a great addition. As for other legends, we have Bam Bam Bigelow, with this one coming from creator Mean Savage Brand, as they've uploaded a classic version of Bam Bam that comes with two of his most recognisable outfits, the first being this black and purple attire, while the second one sees him also in black, this one featuring the red and yellow flame design. Ahead of his return in the upcoming Revel with Wyatt DLC pack, next up we have two versions of Bray Wyatt from creator JokerSpartan #80096. Taking a look at the first version, we have Funhouse Bray Wyatt, which features two attires based on the Firefly Funhouse, as we have this pattern jumper, which is set as the main attire, and then we also have a second one that sees him in red with the Fiend's gloves. The cool thing about this creation is that it comes with all of Wyatt's Funhouse motions to make it feel more authentic, and then once the DLC drops, you'll also be able to update it with his trons and his music. Switching over to the second version of Wyatt, this one's actually my favourite, as Joker has also uploaded this classic version of Bray featuring his Wyatt family gimmick, with this one based around 2014.
A man who always gets a strong reaction from the WWE Universe, and it will only intensify once the bell rings.
So that's the latest creations in WWE 2K23. Let me know what you made of them in the comments, and if there's any specific creations or types of creations that you want to see more of, like updated attires or arenas, then let me know and I'll try and expand the videos out a little bit more in the future. Until then though, thank you so much for watching, have yourself an awesome day, and I'll catch you later.